This is the story of Winnie the Pooh and the Honey Tree. You can read along with me in your book. You will know it is time to turn the page when you hear the chimes ring like this. Let's begin now. Winnie the Pooh lived in an enchanted forest under the name of Saunders, which means he had the name over the door and he lived under it. Now, when Pooh heard his poo-coo clock, he knew it was time for something.
Think, think, think. Oh, yes. Time for my stoutness exercise.
Pooh stood in front of his mirror and tried to touch his toes.
Up, down, and touch the ground. Up, down, and touch the ground.
But instead of making him thin, the exercise made Pooh hungry. So he went to his cupboard, got down a honey jar, and inspected his honey supply.
Oh, bother. Empty again. Only the sticky parts left.
Pooh put his head in the jar and tried to get at the last bit of honey when he heard a buzzing sound.
That buzzing noise means something. And the only reason for making a buzzing noise that I know of is because you're a bee. And the only reason for being a bee is to make honey.
Pooh followed the bee outside to a nearby tree. High in a hole near the top sat a beehive full of honey.
And the only reason for making honey is so I can eat it.
So Pooh began to climb the honey tree. He climbed and he climbed. And just as Pooh neared the beehive, the branch he was standing on broke. And down went Pooh into a very prickly bush below.
Oh, bother.
Pooh brushed the prickles from his nose and decided to go ask Christopher Robin for help.
Christopher Robin, I was wondering if you had such a thing as a balloon about you.
Christopher Robin happened to have just the thing.
But what do you want a balloon for?
Honey, I shall fly like a bee. Up to the honey tree.
Pooh ran off to a very muddy place near the honey tree, and Christopher Robin followed. Pooh rolled around and around until he was covered with mud from his nose to his toes. Christopher Robin scratched his head and wondered what Pooh was up to.
What are you supposed to be, Pooh?
Oh, a little black rain cloud, of course. Now, would you aim me at the bees, please?
Christopher Robin handed Pooh the balloon and launched him into the air. Pooh rose higher and higher toward the hole in the top of the honey tree. And while he hovered outside, a bee flew from the hive and landed on Pooh's nose.
Christopher Robin, I think the bees suspect something. Maybe it would help with the deception if you would open your umbrella and say, "Tut, tut, it looks like rain."
So Christopher Robin opened his umbrella and paced back and forth beneath it.
"Tut, tut, it looks like rain."
The little bee, however, was not fooled. He knew the difference between a rain cloud and a hungry Pooh Bear. So he flew at Pooh and stung him directly on his softest spot.
Oh!
Pooh swung left, then right, then quite by accident swung his very sore bottom into the hole in the tree.
Oh, dear. I'm stuck.
In no time, the bees inside the tree created a mighty force, and they pushed Pooh out of the hole, sending him shooting across the sky. The balloon sputtered, and Pooh came tumbling downward.
Oh, bother. I think I shall come down now.
Pooh fell from the sky with the bees in hot pursuit. Christopher Robin gently caught him, and together they ran to the muddy place and jumped in. Christopher Robin opened his umbrella, and they hid beneath it as the bees buzzed past. The bees did not bother them any more that day. Once Pooh began thinking about honey, he just couldn't stop. So he made his way to Rabbit's house for a light honey snack.
Hello, Rabbit.
Oh, dear. Hello, Pooh Bear. What a surprise. Well, how about lunch?
Pooh sat himself down at the table and tied a napkin around his neck. Rabbit knew perfectly well what Pooh was hungry for. He reluctantly pulled out a honey jar and offered it to Pooh.
Thank you, Rabbit. Just a small helping, please.
Pooh helped himself to Rabbit's honey, and he ate, and he ate, and he ate, and he ate, until there was no honey left.
None at all?
Not a drop. Finally, in a very sticky voice, he excused himself.
I must be going now. Goodbye, Rabbit.
Pooh thanked Rabbit, and he turned to leave. But Pooh's tummy, full of honey, only got halfway out of Rabbit's small front door.
Oh, bother. I'm stuck.
Rabbit pushed at Pooh's round bottom, but it was no use.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear. There's only one thing to do. I'll get Christopher Robin.
Rabbit hurried out of the side door to find his friend. In a short time, Rabbit returned with Christopher Robin.
Cheer up, Pooh Bear. We'll get you out.
Christopher Robin took hold of Pooh, and Rabbit took hold of Christopher Robin. And on the count of three...
One, two, three!
They pulled as hard as they could, but Pooh wouldn't budge.
It's no use. I'm stuck.
Christopher Robin shook his head.
Pooh Bear, there's only one thing to do. Wait for you to get thin again.
Nobody knew how long it would take Pooh to get thin. So poor Rabbit tried to make the best of the situation by decorating Pooh's bottom with a picture frame and some antlers.
There, a hunting trophy. Ah, I know what it needs.
Rabbit then painted a face on Pooh's bottom. It tickled, and Pooh wriggled.
Oh, Pooh, you messed up my moose.
And while Rabbit got along with Pooh's back end, his front end was visited by many friends, including Kanga and Little Roo.
Pooh, Roo has a little surprise for you.
Roo handed Pooh a big bouquet of flowers. Pooh took a deep sniff.
Honeysuckle! Thank you, Roo.
Day after day, night after lonely night, Pooh waited to get thin. And while he waited, who should pop up one night but his good friend Gopher?
I'm working the swing shift, Sonny, but now it's time for my midnight snack.
Gopher opened his lunchbox and inspected its contents, while Pooh looked on with a hungry, feed-me sort of look.
Let's see here. Summer squash, succotash, spiced custard, and honey.
Pooh brightened at the sound of his favorite word.
Honey, could you spare a small smackerel?
But before Pooh could attempt a taste, Rabbit whipped out of his side door and planted a large sign next to Pooh.
Don't feed the bear.
Poor Pooh. Gopher quickly went back to work, and Pooh continued his long and very hungry wait. And then, one morning when Rabbit was beginning to think that he might never be able to use his front door again, it happened. He leaned up against Pooh's bottom and...
He budged! Christopher Crabbin! Christopher Rabbit! He bitched! He badged! He booged! Today is the day!
Almost everyone in the 100-acre wood came running to help. From inside his house, Rabbit pushed frantically on his end of Pooh, while outside, everyone else pulled on the other end.
Heave-ho! Heave-ho!
They tugged and they pushed and they pulled and they shoved with all their might, until suddenly, Pooh shot out of the hole and flew high overhead into the treetops. where he landed in the hole in the honey tree. Christopher Robin called from down below.
Don't worry, Pooh. We'll get you out.
No hurry. Take your time.
For you see, Pooh had landed right in the middle of the beehive and some very yummy honey.
Yum, yum. Bears love honey. And I'm a Pooh Bear. Yum, 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 yum. Time for something sweet.
Christopher Robin shook his head and grinned.
Silly old bear.
The end of the story. If you would like to hear it again, just turn the tape over.